mention one thing that made you very angry, and how did you handle that?
Honourable judges, fellow Toastmasters, my fellow competitors. One thing that made me very angry was my first Toastmasters meeting. I was not angry with my club president, Tony. Hello, Tony. I was not angry with my fellow members. I was angry with myself. What happened on that day was I attended the meeting. I was full of enthusiasm, and I took my seat to quietly observe the meeting. And then came table topics. The cruel and evil table topics master chose me, a first-time guest. Has that ever happened in your club? No, I didn't think so. I approached the stage. The table topic master gave me my topic. I went to open my mouth. My mouth wouldn't open. I went to move my body. My body wouldn't open. And then it happened. I peed my pants. A warm feeling ran through my pelvic region. I'm 28 years old! This hasn't happened to me since I was 6 or 7. I ran out of the room and I vowed to never, ever return to Toastmasters. The next day, our club president Tony called me and he said, Ben, I believe in you. Although today you failed, one day you can be a table topics champion. So I attended the next meeting. Just in case, I wore 2 pair of underpants. I stand before you today so confident in my ability of table topics that today I'm not wearing any underpants. Honourable judges, my fellow Toastmasters, I was very angry at myself when I attended my first Toastmasters meeting because I peed my pants. Contest chair.
A few years ago, that was my first job. I was working as a sales representative in a big pharmaceutical company. I was selling medicines for curement for the cancer. And one old patient, the doctor announced that he has only 2 weeks to live. When I faced him, I told him that, sir, you gotta do me a favor. He say, what? I say, please hang in there. Because if you pass away soon, then you won't use my drug. After saying that, I got home. And I was so angry about myself. Because how could I just care about my sales performance? So I went back to the hospital. I met that old man again. I told him, sir, you gotta do me a favor. He said, what? I say, please hang in there. Because you're important to me. You know, I was so angry about myself, my attitude toward a patient who is going to die. But later on, I changed my attitude. I changed my thoughts. Because I found that he actually lived more than 2 weeks after listening to my 3 words, hang in there. So I became important to him when I told him that 3 words. Ladies and gentlemen, in our life, there are many, many things that we think that's not important to us. But it might be important to people around us. You know, during this convention, many people shake hands with me. They ask me 2 questions. They say, are you a contestant? Yes. And then they ask, when are you going to retire? I was so angry, but they really show their support to me. So ladies and gentlemen, anything you think that's not important, it's important to me and to people around you. Contest chair.
My boyfriend cheated on me. I was very angry. At the time, I was preparing for graduate exam. Can you believe that? I was facing a very big exam in my life. And my boyfriend went out with my best friend, Amanda. And then, I didn't know that. I called him, I say, what were you doing? He said, oh, I was very busy doing my studies. So I didn't have time to pick you up. And I believed him. Until one day, I couldn't find him. And then, I just think, what's wrong with him? What's wrong with him? And I think maybe I was way too busy. So I tried to find out a time. And then I found out he was with my best friend. So I broke up with him. It sounds like I was a very intelligent woman to break up with him. But actually, I went back with him again. So if you ask me, how do I deal with the affair? I cry and then yell at him. And then I would think, I would not go with you again. But remember that if he is your love in your life, you don't want to miss your Mr. Right just because of this mistake. Why do I say that? Because we have been together for 12 years. And I'm getting married. So I think this is the right choice for me. I was great. I did not yell at him and break up with him. I trust him again. And I always promise him I will never, ever mention that affair again. Contest chair.